In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to build a drum track using the Smart Drums, which is the option at the bottom left of the drum icon. By touching on that, you will open up the Smart Drums window. The first thing to do is decide what type of sound you want for your drum track. You can change that by clicking on the Hip Hop Drum Machine icon, and that will then show you the range of drum kits and drum machines available to you in this part of the app. So I'm going to pick Live Rock Kit for this one. You can build a drum pattern by dragging elements from the right hand side into the grid. So we'll start with some hi-hats and add in a kick drum and a snare. And that will then let you hear how the beat sounds. If you'd like to make something louder, you can move up the grid. Quieter, it goes down the grid. More complex, go to the right. And more simple, go to the left. So we can create a basic pattern quite quickly, add in some more percussion, and it will let you hear how the beat sounds. You can switch it off at any point by pressing this power button from the left hand side. If you'd like to turn it back on, press the power button again and you'll hear the beat again. Now you can reset this at any time by pressing reset and you can start again. If you want to bring it all back, you can use the undo button at the top, which is just above the number 3. And if you're looking for new ideas, you can use the dice feature to randomly select a beat for you. And you get a few of those till you find something that you like. When you've found a pattern that you like, you can record it by pressing record. And you'll see the metronome and then the pattern will begin and it'll be recording at the top of the screen. You can even move elements around while it's recording. So say you wanted more cowbell, perhaps because you're in a 70s rock band, you can change it during the recording and it will change the way the cowbell is played. So that's how you build a drum track using Smart Drums in GarageBand.